What is going on, everybody? Now, we were all present back in March of 2020, watching the news, seeing products like toilet paper fly off the shelves. Some even thought it was funny watching the nation's supply of toilet paper disappear in front of them. Well, in preparation for a day that I hope never comes, and mostly out of curiosity, I had to investigate some alternatives to one of our modern day luxuries, toilet paper. Now, some folks may be a little squeamish with this sort of thing, but this is one of those things you'll wish you thought about beforehand. I know we're all big boys and girls here, so I promise not to get too gross, but I can't promise you, you won't raise your eyebrows once or twice. If you like the video and aren't already subscribed, consider doing so. Don't forget to hit the like button if you want to see more content like this. To understand more of the primitive methods, we need to take a brief look at history. You likely could have guessed some of these methods, while others not so much. As far back as ancient Greece, this group used smooth pebbles and ceramic, yes, like the flower pots, to take care of business. Now, I imagine these stones were then discarded, but the best part is there's actually findings that support that in this era, people would write names on stones. Now, some assume these names possibly belong to enemies, and if that's the case, it doesn't get more personal than that. Since we can't go back and ask why people actually did this, it can only be assumed. Take it forward a bit to the Romans, where they used a communal sponge on a stick. Let's just leave it at that. Even so recent as our American ancestors, it seems that the most preferred method was dried corn cobs. There are findings throughout history that show humans really used anything they could get their hands on. From sticks and stones to leaves, grass, seashells, the list goes on. I think it's important to understand how people handled certain tasks in the past to truly understand and discover what is possible without technology if things did go south. Wiping your bum is no different. Since I don't plan on stocking up on seashells, there are a few options we just didn't have before. Let's jump into some of the modern day alternatives, and just remember, all but one of the options below are unsafe to dispose of in a toilet, so before you damage your sewer and septic system, just don't flush these. Wet wipes. Now, I have a few of these stocked up because I have kids. These would be one of my first go-tos. They're probably going to be one of the best alternatives, and as long as you keep them sealed and the containers closed when you're done using them, you might actually look forward to using these things. The supply isn't going to last forever though, so let's look at some other backups. Newspaper. I don't know about you, I don't personally get the newspaper anymore. We live in the digital age where most of the newspapers have gone to the way of the internet, giving everything you need either on your television or your smartphone. It could be an alternative if your toilet supply ever ran low. This would obviously be one of those options for folks that still get the newspaper and you've happened to stock up on them. Towel tablets are extremely easy to store and they take up little space. They're relatively cheap too, with some being sold for as little as a few cents per tablet. I have a couple thousands of these laying around just in case, for many reasons. You'll want to have a disposable alternative to wash the nasties off of something that you might not want to reuse or clean. Using and disposing of your valuable rags or cloths for these reasons will not be preferred in extreme scenarios. Another use for these tablets is, you guessed it, taking care of business. This will be one of my top backups if times call for it. Another common household item, most have Kleenex or tissues in their house at any given point in time. This is likely going to be the first thing most go for in a toilet paper emergency. Not much else to say on this other than they also come in rolled form from some companies, allowing you to store more than you could have in the box versions. It may seem similar to toilet paper, but I have to remind again, don't flush any of these options down the toilet, please. Another product most households will have plenty of is paper. We get paper mail every morning and we have loads of it stocked up for the printer, probably more than we're ever going to use, seeing how we use the printer less and less as time goes on. Notebooks, Christmas cards, even cash, etc. There's likely more backup toilet paper than you realize sitting around your home. I would take this option before I set my eyes on cardboard boxes, thinking most would agree with me on this one. Taking a note from our ancient Roman friends, sponges are used for multiple options, including cleaning. I have a few laying around as backups for cleaning dishes. Depending on the brand and type, this method may or may not be a preferred option. I'm personally staying away from anything that shares the texture of sandpaper. Cloth or clothing. A backup of a backup for me is cloth rags or even clothing that was repurposed. If you're in a situation where going to the local clothing store is not an option, I would not be jumping to this method. Clothes are going to be one of those things that folks took for granted once they find out how fast they go through shirts, pants, socks, etc. Unless you have designated rags for this use and a way to wash them, I would not exercise this option. If you did have some extra rags laying around, you may have just found your most realistic long-term wipe alternative. Snow. If you're lucky or unlucky, depending on how you look at it, to be surrounded by snow as you're squatting in the backcountry, you may have an unlimited supply of toilet paper at your disposal. This could also be an alternative to coffee, as it's guaranteed to wake you up. Using water. There's a few options here. Irrigation or a squeeze bottle. I recently prepped for this one without realizing it. We had an irrigation bottle hanging around for general purposes, but seeing how efficient it is at creating a pressure blast for many different cleaning applications and even medical purposes, I threw this in with my prepping supplies. Touching on the medical application, if you don't have a way to flush out a wound, you may want to consider getting two, one for medical, one for cleaning. Flushing debris out of a cut or scrape will be hard to do if running water is not available. A bidet. If you have running water and you happen to install a bidet, you may be one of those laughing at the rest of us still using toilet paper in the first place. Although much more common in Europe, these seem to be spreading more into the States. Some even have air drying. Again, this is going to be one of those things you want to install ahead of time. And you need to be aware it may not be an option if you lose power or the water company shuts off your supply. But if the stars align and the world continues to operate as normal, you should never need toilet paper again. A bum gun is something that's used heavily in India, which is essentially a spray hose with a nozzle. This is going to allow you to clean without getting up close and personal with your hands. Again, you'll need running water for this option, but these can be installed pretty easily if you have basic plumbing skills and equipment. Most of the versions I found look identical to an old sink spray nozzle with the hose. Enjoy. Another prep I keep around is a spray bottle, for really mostly cleaning purposes. I could see myself using one of these as an alternative. It might be a little awkward to use the spray trigger on some models, but I'm sure I could make it work if I was desperate enough. The last water option is just that, it's water. Preferably warm, having a container of some kind nearby to clean with is going to be a great option that most can afford. If you get up close and personal with this option, just make sure you have plenty of ways to clean and sanitize your hands. Definitely not my first choice. Then there's nature. There are plants that work very well for this purpose, and because of this, you can plan ahead and actually add these to your garden if this is something you'd care to prepare for. But just be sure to invest in plants with soft, large leaves if you go this route. Probably the less preferred option for most, small, smooth rocks, sticks, shells, anything that won't hurt that can be found in nature are also other options. Now, the more preferred options from nature will be plants, as I mentioned, such as corn husks, cobs, maple leaves, mullein, broadleaf plantain, and moss, just to name a few. You'll want to be somewhat skilled when it comes to plant identification, as you'll want to be sure that the leaves you're picking aren't from poison oak or something, for example. But these are just some of the options in the wild that you could memorize, and they're fairly easy to identify. Now keep in mind, I'm only hitting on some of the options I plan to leverage if things went south. It's not a complete list by any means. This may be the one video I regret asking for comments and other alternative folks may have experience with, but as long as we keep it relatively safe, fire away. I hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time, folks.